new. I'm trying to link all my fingers to form a strong fist for a reason. But what reason? I have no idea right now. But promise, I will let you know the time I figure it out. But for now, let's unlink the fingers and start our lesson. Linking is an essential action for strong foundations. Linking builds bridges and closes gaps. It strengthens. So link your mind to your body with breath, as my yoga teacher says. Link your being to another being with affection. Link words to other words with cohesive devices. Or you may call them linking words. Transitional words. Discourse markers, which act as signposts managing the traffic of successive ideas in texts. We have to insert connectives in our train of thoughts, or we can get out of rails and start talking gibberish. Blah, blah, blah. Let's say something meaningful when talking. Right, folks? Cohesion is the reflected concept within this lesson. Cohesion is based on the root hesion, which means to stick. It is the grammatical and lexical linking that holds a text together. Conjunctions, hurufu al-atfi, huruf, letters, al-atf, syndesis, is the state of being bond, linked or connected together, consists of words and letters with different interpretations, different scenarios. They are essentially used as joiners. The use of synthetic constructions enables the text to be written in a certain logical order that is meaningful to the reader or the listener. The prominent letter wow, corresponding to and in English, is a coordinating conjunction that joins words to words, phrases to phrases, clauses to clauses, to create a parallel construction, regardless of the chronological order. You can spot it everywhere. At the beginning of a sentence, around the corner, in between, or when you swear to God. Wallahi. Maybe this is a holy wow. If you need to show your pure honesty, in case you have a reputation of a liar, you may say, Wallahi billahi tallahi, for a strong oath. Let's have an example with the well. Tasafaha adilun wa samirun. So we have adil. Adil is a male given name. So is Samir. So we have adil and Samir shook hands mutually at the same time. So the well conjoins the two people in the same action of shaking hands. Tasafaha. Alright? Su'adu wa Muhammadun. Su'adu is a female given name and it is diptote because it bears a single vowel. Su'adu. We don't say su'adun. Why? I have no idea. Learn it as is. Wa Muhammadun. While Muhammadun is triptote, it is able to receive a tanween, double vowel. Muhammadun. Muhammadun is called ma'atuf in Arabic. Ma'atuf means coupled with the preceding word, which is سعاد. And سعاد is معطوف عليه. معطوف عليه. حرف عطف and معطوف. And if محمد is followed by another conjunction and another word, it will be called معطوف and معطوف عليه at the same time. And معطوف عليه معطوف has to match in case the معطوف عليه. So if معطوف is in the nominative, like this case, محمد will be in the nominative as well. محمد وسعاد ومحمد. يشاهداني. From the verb شاهد, to watch, in the imperfect third person dual masculine, because the subject consists of a male and female. That's why it equals male. It equals masculine. So يشاهداني هما. هما, the subject pronoun هما, referring to third person masculine dual. برنامجهما. برنامج, program. برنامج is in the accusative with the sign of fatha because it is the object of the verb شاهد. And هما is the enclitic form of the subject's pronoun هما. هما هما. Same word. Enclitic form and the subject pronoun. هما referring to their program. برنامج هما. Their program. التلفزيونية. TV program. So التلفزيونية. This ya. And nisba, this emphasized ya, which is called ya and nisba, means that this word is related to another. Which means telefizyuni is related to telefizyun. Telefizyun, TV. Telefizyuni related to TV. Al-mufaddala. المفضلة, favorites. So المفضل is the modifying adjective of برنامج. And since برنامج is a masculine noun, its modifying adjective has to match in number, gender, and case. So it is also masculine, المفضلة. Masculine. التلفزيونية. Matching in case. برنامج تلفزيونية المفضلة. And they are all definite. The time we attached a pronoun to the noun, that means that it is already definite. We make it definite because we are talking about their program. We have defined it as their program, not any program. Telefizyuni with the sign of, with the definite article el, and al mufaddal is also definite. Wa. Wa. There is the conjunction wa. Let's see what is it linking. يتناولاني. See how the construction is parallel. يتناولاني. يشاهداني. The verb تناول, to eat, also conjugated in the imperfect third person dual masculine. يتناولاني سعاد ومحمد هما. يتناولاني, and they are eating popcorn. الفشارة. So سعاد and محمد are watching their favorite TV program and they are eating popcorn. يتناولاني الفشارة. و يشرباني شاي النعناع يشرباني from the verb شربا. Also in the imperfect third person dual masculine. So يشاهداني شاهدا يتناولاني تناولا يشرباني شربا شاي النعناع mint tea. This is an idafa construction, first term, second term. Last term of an idafa is always in the genitive, here with the sign of a kasra. Shaya an-na'na'i. See how it is all connected with the conjunction waw. Alright. We could say Su'ad wa Muhammad yushahidani barnamajahuma at-televiziyoniya al-mufaddala wa Su'ad wa Muhammad yatanawalani al-fushar wa Su'ad, but it will be redundant. Alright. السماء صافية والبحر هادئ. السماء, the sky, is clear. السماء صافية, the sky is clear. And و, our next sentence. البحر هادئ و the sea is calm. Here I am enumerating the scenes of my surroundings combined in one picture related to nature. ما تقوله وما تفعله. This is our compound subject. ما referring to inanimate. So ما means what. تقوله from the verb قال. قال is conjugated here in the imperfect second person singular. أنت, you. Who, who, the object pronoun who refers to what you say, to your speech. Who is a resumptive pronoun. And ما تفعله and what you do, the verb فعل, to do. Again, they are conjugated in the same, in the imperfect. We have the same tense and the same structure. It's like if they are doubled. So ما تقوله وما تفعله. Who referring to your action. So this is the subject. Here is the predicate. So هما, this is redundant. This is a nominal sentence. This is the predicate of this subject. So huma is a subject pronoun referring to the third person dual masculine, referring to this and this. شيئاني, two things, is the dual of the word شيء. شيء, a thing. متناقضان, contradicting. So what you say and what you do are two contradicting things. The letter فاء, the letter فاء, which equals two, and then consequently, hence, so, then, therefore, thereupon, thus is another coordinating conjunction that joins consecutive events that are following closely with no time gap, back to back. For example, رأيت سعيدا فصالحا. They are both male given names. So رأيت سعيدا فصالحا. I saw سعيد then صالح, but right away, immediately, just a second after, I saw صالح. دخل المدرس فوقف التلاميذ. So the teacher entered, therefore the pupil stood up. So back to back. So the teacher got in the classroom and right away the students stood up. Here, أجاب الطالب السؤال الأول ف الثانية ف الثالثة. Back to back. So here, the student, الطالب, answered the first question, then the second question, then the third question, with non-stop, back to back. So, and in sequence. دخلت المطبخ فبدأت أطبخ. طبخ, to cook. So, دخلت المطبخ. I walked into the kitchen. Then I started cooking right away, automatically. So, دخلت المطبخ فبدأت أطبخ. The coordinating conjunction ثم, which is compared to after that, afterwards, later on, next, subsequently, then, thereafter, joins ideas chronologically and forms a loose connection. What does that mean? It means that there is a considerable interval between the consecutive events, during which other occurrences may take place. Contrary to fa, for fa, the events, they have to be back to back. For example, let's see. دخل التلاميذ ساحة المدرسة ثم انتقلوا إلى الفصل. So here our first sentence. دخل التلاميذ ساحة المدرسة. So the pupils entered the school yard. ساحة المدرسة. The school yard. Later on, they moved to the classroom. So here, after the students entered the school yard, maybe they went to the cafeteria, maybe they went to the restroom, and then they moved to their classrooms. So there is that big time gap in between the first action of entering the schoolyard and the second action, which is entering the classroom. مشيت إلى محطة الأوتوبيس ثم قررت أخذ القطار. So مشيت, from the verb مشى, to walk. I walked to the bus station. مشيت in the perfect first person singular, أنا. مشيت إلى, مشى is construed with إلى. مشيت إلى محطة الأوتوبيس. I walked to the bus station. Then I decided to take the train. But before this decision, I just sat there for a while. I checked my phone, I talked to people, and then I decided to take the train. Maybe because the bus was too late. حضر الضيوف ثم تشاجروا. The guests came. حضر. Ad-duyufu, the guests, ad-duyuf, came, hadara. Then they quarreled, tashajara, to fight, to argue, to quarrel. But before the fight, they sat together and enjoyed talking to each other or eating, whatever. Maybe it lasted for hours before they decided to start fighting. I enjoy this scene so much when my guests start fighting. It's time to go, people. The coordinating conjunction aw, that means or in English, is used when you are not sure, not exactly sure about a person, a thing or place. For example, wasaltu qablahu aw ba'dahu. La adhkur. I don't remember. I don't recall. So wasaltu, I arrived before or after him. Qablahu, before him. This who referring to him. Ba'dahu, him. See how it's balanced? Qablahu aw ba'dahu. So I arrived before or after him. I'm not sure. I don't remember. It is also used when an option is granted. For example, سافر بقطاري أو بالطائرتي. سافر from the verb سافر in the imperative, second person singular, masculine. سافر, travel by train or by plane. I'm giving you an option of the two. So it's up to you. You can travel by train or by plane. It's your choice. The coordinating conjunction am, they are almost similar, which also means or, but one is used to specify, to identify clearly and definitely. For example, a akelta tufahan am burtuqalan. So, have you eaten apples or oranges? Tell me which one. So, tufah, apples, the plural of tufaha, oranges. Burtuqal, the plural of burtuqala. So, have you eaten apples or oranges? And you will let me know. Apples or oranges. Here, have you noticed the double hamza? This is not a mistake. So the second one belongs to the verb akela, but the first one is an initial interrogative particle and is written together with the following word. It is synonym to hal. So I may substitute the hamza with hal akalta tufahan am burtuqalan. A najaha faridun am bilalun. Hal najaha faridun am bilalun. Did Farid or Bilal succeed? Which one? Did Farid or Bilal succeed? An-najaha Faridun am Bilalun? Hal anta Masriyun am Lubnaniyun? Are you Egyptian or Lebanese? In contrast to English and some other languages, Arabic is proven to be conjunction dense due to the frequent employment of wa and fa as default markers, which carry little semantic content and are merely meant and are mainly meant to smooth and naturalize the flow of discourse. Let's all say that we lived, laughed, cried, loved, hated, rejoiced, mourned, and left. But in Arabic, فلنقل عشنا وضحكنا وبكينا وأحببنا وكرهنا وفرحنا وحزننا وغادرنا إلى اللقاء.